We want to simplify the given expression. To simplify the expression, we must follow the order of operations shown below. Step 1, we perform all operations within grouping symbols. Grouping symbols include parentheses, brackets, braces, fraction bars, as well as absolute values. So looking at the given expression, notice how it is in fraction form, and therefore, we simplify the expression in the numerator and the denominator separately, and then in the last step, we simplify the fraction. We can also think of having a set of parentheses around the numerator and denominator. And because a fraction bar means division, the given expression is equivalent to the expression where we have the numerator in parentheses divided by the denominator in parentheses. But let's go ahead and simplify it in the original form, just keeping in mind we simplify the top and bottom separately before simplifying the fraction. So looking at just the numerator, because we treat absolute values as grouping symbols, the first step is to perform the subtraction inside the absolute value, 3 minus 10 is equal to negative 7. Now looking at just the denominator, again because we treat absolute values as grouping symbols, the first step is to determine this product, 2 times 1.2 is equal to 2.4. So the given expression is equal to the expression where the numerator would be 7 plus the absolute value of, again, 3 minus 10 is equal to negative 7. 3 minus 10 is the same as 3 plus negative 10. Now looking at the denominator, we would have 5 times the absolute value of 2 times 1.2 is equal to 2.4. So we have 5 times the absolute value of 2.4 minus negative 4. Now looking at just the numerator again, because we're treating the absolute value as grouping symbols, the next step is to determine the absolute value of negative 7, which equals positive 7. Looking at just the denominator, again because the absolute value is treated as a grouping symbol, the next step is to determine the absolute value of positive 2.4, which is positive 2.4. So the given expression is equivalent to the expression where the numerator would be 7 plus positive 7, and the denominator would be 5 times positive 2.4 minus negative 4. Now looking at just the numerator, there's only one operation left. The next step in the numerator is to determine the sum of 7 and 7, which equals 14. Looking at the denominator, notice how we have multiplication and subtraction. So looking at the order of operations, we skip step 2 because there are no exponents or radicals. Step 3, we multiply or divide from left to right. So the next step on the bottom is to determine this product. 5 times 2.4 is equal to 12. So the expression is equal to the expression where the numerator would be 7 plus 7, which equals 14. And the denominator would be, again, 5 times 2.4 is equal to 12, so we have 12 minus negative 4. So the numerator is simplified. There's only one operation left in the denominator. So the next step in the denominator is to determine this difference. 12 minus negative 4 is the same as 12 plus 4. So if I wanted to, we could write this as 14 over 12 plus 4. And 12 plus 4 is equal to 16. So the given expression simplifies to 14 sixteenths, but this fraction does simplify because 14 and 16 share a common factor of 2. So to simplify 14 sixteenths, we'll divide the numerator and denominator by 2. 14 divided by 2 is equal to 7. 16 divided by 2 is equal to 8. The given expression simplifies 2/7/8. I hope you found this helpful.